it turns out that you actually have to stop and declare failure. And if you don't do that, then you're still on your way to success. I'm John Collins, the paper airplane guy, and for the last 10 years, I've been throwing paper airplanes for a living. I just love flight, and I love paper airplanes in particular. In middle school, pretty much through high school, I was a nerd. I loved math and science. I was not the athlete guy. I was pretty much the paper airplane guy, only kind of on the down low back then. I was the guy who would make a great paper airplane, hand it to somebody who would then get busted and go to the office. That was me. That was my gig. So even back then, I was a trouble with paper airplanes. I had a lot of great teachers, particularly in high school. I can remember my speech coach, who I frustrated on any number of occasions. She was terrific. I had a great social studies teacher who really just kind of treated us like adults, and I kind of never experienced that from a teacher before. I really admired a couple of folks from the aviation field, the first guys to win the Ansari X Prize. They had lots of money working against them, and it was the private enterprise guys. The private enterprise guys got it done. And to me, that kind of told me, hey, it just takes dedication and study. Doesn't necessarily take a lot of funding or sales effort or whatever. If you just really keep your eye on it, you can get it done. So I was pretty young when we landed on the moon for the first time, but I remember it. I remember that. I remember Apollo 13, which was, I think I was in middle school when Apollo 13 happened, and the whole school, the whole county, everybody was on edge for that one. That was really a big moment. Everyone was super worried. And when the clock was ticking by, and then when they finally got most of their technical problems solved and they're heading back through the atmosphere, they took longer to get through the atmosphere than anyone had before. We were all just dreading being told what happened to these guys. And then that moment of elation, when we find out, no, they survived, it's all okay. All that hard work that they did, all those things they figured out on the fly, it all worked out. And that was just amazing. What a feeling. To experience that in a whole classroom full of people, it was just amazing. The biggest advice I would give to students is regarding success and failure. It took 3 years to break the world record. And all of that time, I looked at each thing that we had tried as just a data point. We tried this, I made an adjustment, that didn't work. So I never really looked at it in terms of success and failure. Success is super easy to measure, right? Did you make the world record distance? You know, yes or no, that's you know, binary. But you know, failure is a little more complicated. It turns out that you actually have to stop and declare failure. And if you don't do that, then you're still on your way to success. And that's the way I kept going over 3 years of progress toward making the world record, is that you can't just take no for an answer. It's much easier if you just view it as data. You don't view it as like a personal thing. You've just tried X, Y, and Z. Now you got to go back and try J, H, and K. I've always been curious about basically everything. Maybe that's why I like math and science so much. It just seems like we have this stack of really cool stuff that if you're a human, you should avail yourself of. But that just comes naturally, I think, if you're just curious about things. It's just like every little bit you learn about anything in the world, how can you just not have more questions? And it's just this never-ending push forward.